Hey Annie, say hi.
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 Say hi, Annie.
Hi, Annie. Hi.
Hi.
Say hi.
Hi.
But she used to say hi. In this raspy little voice that she had that just warmed everybody's heart.
I'm the nanny.
My relationship to Annie, I'm Annie's Uncle Peck.
My relationship to Annie is I am her aunt.
Annie's my little cousin.
My daughter Bridget, they were in kindergarten together. And
my relationship to Annie is I am her cousin.
Name is Jennifer McGann, and I am Annie's aunt.
I am Annie's aunt, Megan's sister, her mother's sister.
Annie. My relationship to Annie is that I'm her cousin.
I am Annie's younger sister, Madeline.
I'm Annie's younger sister, Alice.
Okay. I'm her mother.
I am her father.
What'd you have for breakfast?
A donut and chocolate.
Cheese.
And chocolate ice cream.
Wow. For breakfast? Man. Oh, look at you.
And look at my hair.
Look at your hair.
It's the bunny toy. Allie's chasing me.
She is. Annie got all the presents.
They weren't really stuck in my mind. Kind of sad, but I gotta tell it. Everybody went someplace, but Annie and I, and she's out on the driveway riding her tricycle, and I realized, well, there's nobody home but her and I. And I said, Annie, you know, there's no one here but you and I. I said, what am I gonna do with you? I said, she just looked. I said, well, how about if I put you up in a tree? No. I said, well, how about on top of the shed? No. I said, well, what do you want me to do with you? She said, just love me.
She was very motherly. She was like a little Mother Hubbard type. Liked things to be done right, liked things to be done a certain way. Very sweet, always sweet.
The thing I remember about Annie the most was that she was on the quiet side. And she was just very sweet and smiling all the time.
I remember Annie as always being very sweet and quiet. She had like a quiet, she could talk her head off, But she also had this quiet nature to her.
Her that came in and placated everybody. And I just remember her running around with her toothless grin and special holidays. She was always happy.
Obviously the teeth. I always waited for her teeth to come in. She had the best smile. I don't know if it was because the teeth were missing or what, but she just had a wonderful smile.
Annie always made me laugh and smile, and she was one of my best friends when I was little.
One of the biggest things I remember was her wearing her jean jacket. And it was this really cool jean jacket. It was like kind of old looking. And when she would see her mom, she would just run out and just hug her.
Here's Annie. What's today, Annie?
Tomorrow!
What's today?
Tomorrow!
But what's today?
Tomorrow!
Today's not tomorrow.
What is it?
What's today?
Tomorrow!
It's your birthday!
It's my birthday!
Yay! And how old are you? Wait a minute. How old? Show me. That's right! 3! You, what? Where are you? Jeez! And me. You do?
Yeah. It's locked.
Is that Annie?
Annie's locked.
Alice, come here.
Let me say, go.
Don't you take that off.
Daddy, watch.
Come on.
I've never been so scared in my life. She, I thought that she was lost forever. I was babysitting. Finally, I was allowed to take you guys, the four of you, in the pool, just me, which was like a big deal because before somebody else had to be there, but like I was like, I want to say like 16 and a half or something, so like we went swimming and this big storm was coming in. It was like one of those storms where like things start blowing around and I'm like, okay, we need to get inside and like out of the pool. And like she had just asked me, she was like, can I have a ice cream cone? Or no, it was an ice cream sandwich. And I was like, no, you just had like 3, what do you call those things?
Popsicle.
Flavor ice, yeah. And she was like, okay. And like, well, I was like, well, let's get inside. And I got you all inside, and, like, Malin was, like, a baby, and Alice was still really little, and, like, I was like, where's Annie? And she was just gone, and you were older, and you helped me look for a good 15 minutes. You start crying. I start crying. I'm like, my God, where is she? Like, and it's the weather outside was not helping, like, how stressed we were. There was, like, a, like, literally, like, black clouds rolling in, and, like, we're outside, like, Annie! Annie, it's like 6 o'clock and you're like, where is she? This went on for like 20 minutes, so I finally was like, all right, I have to call my mom and tell her that I lost Aunt Meg's kid. So I called my mom and was like, I can't find Annie. And my mom's like, what? I'm like, I wouldn't call you if I wasn't positive that I cannot find her. We've already looked really hard. My mom goes, I'll be there in 25 minutes. I'm like, do I call Aunt Megan? What? I can't tell Aunt Megan. I can't. And my mom's like, just, we're not calling her yet. I'll be there in 25 minutes. So we're sitting, the storm's just full on. There's like rain coming a little bit. Like it's like starting to happen. And we're out on you had the porch swing and you're sitting there crying and Alice is crying now and Malin doesn't even know what's going on. And I was just like, where could she have gone? Like she was just here. And then my mom pulls in the driveway, like whips in like 50 miles an hour and gets out of the car. She's like, where is she? I was like, I don't know. I can't find her. And then Annie just comes out of like the front door of your house with like ice cream all over her face. I'm like, where have
you been? I like got down. I was like, where were you? She's like, I'm sorry. I was hiding. I was like, you can't hide from me. Like, no wonder I couldn't find you. I was walking past you yelling your name and you're like laughing under a table. I was like, I called my mom, made my mom come, and I couldn't even be mad at her because she just had so much ice cream all over her face. And she's like, I'm sorry, I was just hiding and I wanted my ice cream. I'm like, okay. My mom's so mad at me. She was like, you need to watch them better. I'm like, watch them? She was hiding from me. Yeah, that's sneaky Annie.
Mom, get your camera.
I always called her the little Polish girl because she used to come in. She had a costume, and it was one of them Polish costumes, and I had it in the house, and she put it on, you know, and she would dance around. She was always dancing, always happy.
We get it almost every night. And when that moon gets a big and bright, it's supernatural delight. Every border was dancing. Everybody here is out of sight. They don't bark and they don't bite. They keep things loose, they keep things alive. Everybody was dancing in the moonlight.
Dancing in the moonlight. Everybody's feeling warm and bright. It's such a fine and natural sight. Everybody dancing in the moonlight.
We like our fun. Never fight. You can't dance and stay uptight. It's supernatural delight. Everybody was dancing in the moonlight.
Dancing in the moonlight. Everybody feeling warm and bright. It's such a fine and natural sight. Everybody's dancing in the moonlight.
Tragic, but it's the one I hold the most dear in my heart, and I hope I don't embarrass you, Annie. But when we were at the circus, and it was time to go, and of course the crowd rushes out the doors, so there's all these people, and Annie had to poop. And everyone knew that when Annie had to poop, it was going to be a while. So your mother's like, oh, and I said, don't worry, go out with the rest of the kids, I'll meet you outside. I'll take her to poop. So we go into this bathroom. I can close my eyes and just visualize it. And Annie goes in the stall. I said, I'm waiting right here for you. She goes, okay. And then like 3 minutes go by. And Erin, I said, I'm still here. And you could just see your little feet. The swing and the swing. And she always took her out. So finally, I think your mother even, you came with me too, actually, but you went, boom, wash your hands, out you went. And so then your mom waited, and then I said, just go ahead, go outside, I'll bring her out. So she did her thing and took a long time, and then she comes out of the stall, she goes and washes her hands, because she said, I have to wash my hands. I said, of course. Washes her hands very methodically and then dried them under a dryer. And then we go out the door to leave. And just as we, you came out of the bathroom, we walked down just this large open area, and there was the door, and everyone was waiting outside. And just as we got to the door, and we were going out, she turned to me, and she threw her arms around me. And she said, "Thank you, Aunt Erin, I love you." Just because I waited for her to poop, because she knew everybody, she was a long pooper. But I looked at her little face, and I reached down and hugged her and squeezed her and kissed her and said, "Anytime, Annie, I love you too." And unfortunately, that was the last time that I saw Annie. But it's not a sad story for me, because this beautiful little angel who took her time pooping with her, all I remember, those little legs. "You okay, Annie?" "Mm-hmm." She just took her time. And then she just gave me a big old hug and said, "Thank you, Aunt Erin." Because she meant that I would wait with her. So I know that's a corny story, but for me, it's very special. Because I was with her, and she went out the door and went to the right, and I went to the left. And that was the last time I saw her.
I could talk to Annie right now, I would say that I miss her and I love her, and I remember doing like the playground and how fun it was, and I wish you could be here with us.
Mine's me, Annie.
Yeah.
She is. Really does. Annie. Annie, this one's gonna be like you.
Annie, you'll be so happy.
I got you all worked up.
That means Manny too.
Even whines like you, Annie.
I miss you and I love you.
Hi, Annie!
Her sweet smile. She was our toothless Annie, and I'll never know what she'll look like with front teeth, but it was the sweetest smile without them, and she smiled all the time. She just mothered everyone, and
so sick. I mean, that was the thing. It was a Christmas, and we were over your Aunt Erin's and Papa, and they we had Christmas over there, and she had the flu, and she was so bad, and everybody's enjoying the time and everything, and she just wanted her cheerful self, but yet she. It didn't matter. She was still there and wanted to make everyone happy and just didn't think about herself and being sick. She just tried to be a part of everything, but you could tell, oh my gosh, she was just so out of it. And so she would kind of go out, be her own little self and off to the side, and then all of a sudden she'd come back and be with everybody, and then she'd just be so out of it. And she'd be there and we'd all be laying and talking and go out, and then she was in and out and came to opening presents. So sure enough, we'd give her presents around, and she was so out of it, and gave her a present, and she kind of came through, and she just looks there, and she takes it, and opens, and rips it open, and she takes all the paper off, and she goes, I got a box. She didn't bother opening it, nothing. She just tears the paper, and that was her. She just didn't even fathom, to open the box and see what she got, and it was a great present that's inside, but I got a box. And she just kind of got sad and started to cry. And we're like, no, Annie, it's okay. You didn't. It's not a box. Open it. And, everybody just laughed. I mean, we all just laughed so hard. But you felt bad. And then she's looking at you like, why are you laughing at me? And I loved that so much. And it was just one of those times that I just never forget, And there's always these precious moments.
I just got a box.
You just got a box?
Yeah.
Aw. Well, we need to go get you a present. Come on. Hey, Mom.
Sunny days seem to hurt the most. I wear the pain like a heavy coat. I feel you everywhere I go. I see your smile, I see your face. I hear you laughing in the rain. I still can't believe you're gone. It ain't fair, you died too young, like a story that hadn't just begun. But death tore the pages all away. God knows how I miss you, all the hell that I've been through. Just knowing no one could take your place. Sometimes I wonder who you'd be today. Would you see the world? Would you chase your dreams? Settle down with a family? I wonder what would you name your baby? Some days the sky's so blue, I feel like I can talk to you. And I know it might sound crazy. It ain't fair, you died too young, like a story that hadn't just begun. But death tore the pages all away. God knows how I miss you, all the hell that I've been through. Just knowing no one could take your place. Sometimes I wonder who you'd be today. 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 Sunny days seem to hurt the most. I
wear the pain like a heavy coat. The only thing that gives me hope is I know I'll see you again someday. Someday, someday.
Say hi, Alice.